Good morning, students. In this session, we will be seeing about primary nursing. So the history of primary nursing, that is a cultural revolution, occurred in the United States during 1960, and the revolution influenced the nursing profession because the nurses were becoming dissatisfied with their lack of autonomy. So the nurses were not getting proper control over their profession. So this creates some dissatisfaction, and the search for autonomy and quality care led to the primary nursing system of patient care delivery. Next, we'll see what is this primary nursing. Primary nursing, it is an adaptation of case method. That is, we have seen the case method in the previous class. So the case method, one nurse is responsible for the total patient care. So this is also a modification of case method. This method was developed by Mary Manthe as a method for organizing patient care delivery, in which, this you have to learn, one RN, and she functions autonomously as the patient's primary nurse throughout the hospital stay. So here, this registered nurse, she functions autonomously as the patient's primary nurse. So that is the primary nursing. This registered nurse is the primary nurse, and this primary nurse is taking care of the patient throughout the hospital stay. And that particular primary nurse is accountable and responsible for each and everything about patient. So this is the primary nursing model. In the middle, you can see a primary nurse. She has 24 hours responsibility for planning, directing and evaluating the patient care. And you can see the physician and other members of the healthcare team, and they are also coordinating with the primary nurse. And the primary, under the primary nurse, there is an associate nurse, and she provide care when primary nurse is off duty. But the primary nurse is accountable or responsible for every care of the patient. Like, even if she is off duty, or in that situation also she is responsible. So this is the primary nursing model. Next is about the characteristics of primary nursing. The primary nurse is accountable for the patient's care 24 hours a day from admission throughout discharge. So at the time of admissions, like for example, the patient with diabetic ketoacidosis got admitted in the casualty. So from the time of admission, this primary nurse is planning everything for the patient. After discharge also, she is planning for the like a further feedback or further follow-up, even services also. And second, primary nursing care provides the patient and family with coordinated, comprehensive and continuous care. Here the care is coordinated, and here the care is continuous. Next is, the care is organized using the nursing process. So from the time of admission, the primary nurse is providing nursing assessment, diagnosis, planning, implementation and evaluation. The primary nurse collaborates, communicates and coordinates all aspects of patient care with other nurses as well as other disciplines. So like, she is coordinating the care with the help of other disciplines like physiotherapy, dietary department, exercise, counseling and everything. Next is, advocacy and assertiveness are desirable leadership attributes for this care delivery model. So the primary nurse, she is accountable for everything, but she should possess certain leadership attribute like advocacy and assertiveness. Next is, the associate nurse is an RN. So the like, in the absence of a primary nurse, associate nurse is providing care with the help of primary nurse, but the associate nurse, she should be an registered nurse who has been delegated to provide care to the patient according to the primary nurse specification. So even like, if she get any doubt regarding patient care, she should immediately communicate with the primary nurse. So the primary nursing, you can see there is a communication, and she should be accountable. There is a patient-centered advocacy is there, and the primary nurse is responsible for a particular patient throughout the time of admission, throughout the time of hospital stay. So individualized care, and the primary nurse has some autonomy to give patient care. She is committed to give, and there is a continuity of care. She is responsible, and she coordinates and collaborates with other discipline, and there is a decentralized care. So the authority is given to the primary nurse. Then coming further, you can see here, you can see the model patient, total patient care 24 hours per day by primary nurse, and she communicates with supervisors, consult with physician or other healthcare providers, and you can see the associate nurse when primary nurse is not available in the morning, associate nurse when primary nurse is not available in the evening, and associate night when primary nurse is not available. But this associate nurse should communicate with the primary nurse. Example of primary nursing: a patient is admitted to a medical unit with pulmonary edema. Primary nurse admits him and then provide a written plan of care. When his primary nurse is not working, an associate nurse implements the plan. If the patient develops additional complication, the associate nurse notifies the primary nurse, who has 24-hour accountability and responsibility. So the fact is that the primary nurse is 24-hour accountable and responsible about the patient care, even if she is off duty. Okay, then we'll see the advantages of primary nursing. In the system of care delivery, professionalism is promoted, because registered nurse practicing primary nursing must possess a broad knowledge base and have highly developed nursing skills. So that is the first advantage: professionalism is promoted by broad knowledge base and highly developed nursing skills. Next is, nurses experience job satisfaction because they can use their education to provide holistic and autonomous care for the patient. So this terminology nowadays, it is known as relationship based care. Next is, there is a high level of accountability for patient. So the registered nurse is highly accountable for the patient. In primary nursing, patients and families are typically satisfied with the care they receive because they establish a relationship with the primary nurse and identify the caregiver as their nurse. So here you can see there is an improved communication and satisfaction with the patient because the patient identifies the primary nurse as their caregiver. Next is, because the patient's primary nurse communicates the plan of care, the patient can move away from the sick role and begin to participate in his or her own recovery. Next, by considering the socio-cultural, psychological and physical needs of patient and family, primary nurse can plan the most appropriate care with and for the patient and family. Next is, there is a decrease in the number of unlicensed personnel because the primary nurse and the associate nurse, they all are skilled registered nurses. Okay. We are moving to the last slide. Disadvantages, that is, the registered nurse may not have the experience or educational background to provide total care. She should have proper experience and educational background. Next is, willingness and capability of RN for handling the 24-hour responsibility for patient care. Next is, nurse practice acts must be evaluated to determine whether primary nurses can be held accountable when they are not physically present. So if they are not physically present also, they should have maintained proper communication with the associate nurse. So that is another disadvantage, is whether this RN is willing to hold accountability even if she is off duty. So that is the disadvantages. This is about the primary nursing. So hope you understood this. Thank you.